फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कस सम ऑफ द एशियन सिविलाइजेशन, दैट इन वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इजिप्टियन सिविलाइजेशन, मेसोपोटामिया एंड अनदर वन इज चाइनीज सिविलाइजेशन. सो दीज आर द मैटर्स वी आर डिस्कस्ड इन लास्ट सेशन. सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग नेक्स्ट अनदर टू इम्पोर्टेंट सिविलाइजेशन इन वर्ल्ड. सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट, दैट इज ग्रीक सिविलाइजेशन, सेकेंड वन इज रोमन सिविलाइजेशन. सो दिस इन बोथ सिविलाइजेशन ऑल्सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन दिस क्लास. So first one we want to know about Greek civilization. So when we are discussing about the Greek civilization, this is one of the important civilization because of the civilization given so much of contribution to world. In all the subject, we cannot say any one subject. There are a lot of contribution given by Greek civilizations in all the sectors. And what we are discussing, there are so much of theory or ideology, the basement provided by Greek. So that's why this is one of the important civilization in the world. So when we are discussing about the Greek civilization, here they say the Greek is a peninsular country like India. So India is one of the important peninsular country. Same that like only Greek also one of the important peninsula. Peninsula means we already knowing. Three sides covered by water, remaining part one side is land. So this like a part where we are calling as a peninsula. So Greek also here they saying peninsula in the Mediterranean Sea. After that here they saying this Greek is dividing by mountains and valleys. There are some of the mountains and slope areas they are dividing by Greek country. And next one here they saying, so specially in Greek, which race of peoples they are living? Here they are saying Indo-European race of peoples. So this like of tribes we can say, and there are three important tribes also we can see in Greek in beginning of civilization, beginning time. So here they are saying first one is Aeolians and Lyonians and Dorians. So these are the three important tribes we can see in ancient times of Greek. So and next one here they are saying, after that we can see first time we are discussing about city and state concept in Greek civilization. Because we cannot get any information about city and state about any civilization. So what we discussed in Egyptian, Mesopotamia or another one we are discussed about Chinese civilization. So in this civilization we are not get information about city state. First time we are getting information about city state in Greek civilization. So here they say, in before 3000 years ago, we can see in Greek civilization also like other civilization like they was established by villages. So after that, here they're saying the village is expanded and who is took that one village for leader as a king. King took a leader and he advised to the peoples. He given advice to peoples. After that, this village slowly developed as a town. So after that, the town developed as a city state. So this like we can see in Greek civilization the concept of city state is evaluated or created. So this like they say, and each city and state also we can see some of the features. They have special separate, they have security force, that only they saying the army force, and they also have own administrative system and guardian duties. Means they have own god to believe, to worship, each city and state also. So these like of features we can see in city and state, and each city and state also independent. What are the city state we are seeing in Greek civilization? All the city and state that is independent. There is no other state or other city could not take the control of against city or state. So that like of features we can see in city and state in Greek civilization. So in that based of the city and state concept, we can see there are two important states are important in Greek civilization. There are two states or two cities are important. One is here they saying that is Athens, second one is Sparta. So Athens and Sparta both also they're very important city in Greek civilization. So why that one both also very important? Because of they given so much of contribution to world society. So on this page now we want to discuss about political history of Greek civilization. So in that now we are discussing there are two important city. One is Athens, second one is Sparta. And we are discussing about, so who is king ruled by that particular city and what was the contribution they have given, any achievements they have done. So these are the matters we are discussing now. So first one here they given, that is Athens. Athens is one of the ideal city of Greek civilization, and this city adapted by democracy system. Athens is one of the example for city and state model. This is the model for city and state, how we can build a state, what was the policy or programs we want to implement in city inside. And not only this one, the adapted by the government is democracy. So that like of city Athens. So here next one they say, in that Athens they took by control, here they are saying that is Cleosthenes. Cleosthenes, this family or this dynasty took control by Athens. After that here they are saying, after that 2005 years ago, after that, after remaining, after the kingship, one of the new government established in Athens, that is democracy. So after that here they are saying, after the democracy, once again in that place controlled by another dynasty. So that one here they give a name as a Pericles. So they took the control of that particular place, Athens. Here they saying this Pericles period they calling as a the golden period of Athens, because of they given that much of contribution in the field of science, art, literature and philosophy. So these are the area, these are the subject spread by all over the Athens state. And the prince, the dynasty of Pericles also they given support in all the sector. So that's why they give a name as a the golden period of Athens. So that like they say, after that here they say Pericles called Athens as a the school of Hellas. The school of Hellas, because of in Athens they providing in knowledge about all the sector. They given that much of free for peoples, and they given that much of facilities to the peoples, and they maintain and they encourage to all the sectors. So that's why Pericles they called as Athens as a the school of Hellas. So that way they called. So after that, second one, another important state, city and state in Greek, that is Sparta. So Sparta also one of the important city. Here they saying city of Dorens, it was military state. Athens we have discussed, that is democratic, and they ruled by in beginning kingships, after that one second democracy, after that one second dynasty. So but here they saying, here we can see city of Dorens, this is one type of tribes. These like a peoples we can see, Dorens tribes we can see in Sparta city. And here established by the government, that is military government. So that one they established it. And here they say, when Persia king, here they saying, when the Persia king Dorus, he started against war against the Sparta. On that time, here they say, Sparta and Athens both also together, they battled against Persian king and they defeated the in that battle. So this is one of the important achievement in city of Sparta. So after that, finally here they saying Athens also they lost and become a part of Sparta. So finally after that, after the Pericles, the Athens state also declined. So that Athens state merged with Sparta. So these like we can see, there are two important city and state in Greek civilization, that is Athens and Sparta. In Athens in democracy government, Sparta in military government. So now we want to discuss what was the contribution they given to world society by Greek civilization. Already I told in beginning, they given numerous contribution to world society by Greek civilization. We cannot count it. So that much of contribution given by Greek civilization in all the sector, in all the field. So what are the subject we are discussing? In that all the subject we can see the basement of contribution given by Greek civilization. That much of knowledge, that much of facilities they provided by in that particular society. So now we want to discuss here they are saying one by one. Before that they are saying, first one, the temple of Zeus in Olympia. This one built by Greek. And not only this one, next one they are saying, in that Zeus or in that Olympia place, the all the city and state peoples, they together, they conducted by some of the programs, some of the sports. Not only they called as the Olympics. Now present in we can see overall almost all the country they participating in the sports of Olympics. So this Olympics is started by Greek civilization peoples. So this is one of the important contribution. After that, as I say, and we can see in philosophy field in also Greek peoples, they given so much of contribution. One of the best example, Plato is one of the famous political thinker. After that, his students, Aristotle, he developed by political subject of political science. So these, like, we can see there are so much of philosophers also, they came in that particular place in Macedonia. So here they're saying Socrates next year, they're saying here. After that, first one is Plato next one they're saying Socrates. After that, here they're saying Socrates. After the Socrates, his student came Plato. After the Plato, here they're saying Aristotle, he took the control. After that, Aristotle, he given the guidelines. So based on the guidelines, one of the important emperor emerged in the world. So that is Alexander. Alexander, he came in Macedonia. So who is given guidelines to Alexander, how we can expand the dynasty, or how we can implement the programs in that particular dynasty. So these are the matters given guidelines by Aristotle. We all are knowing Aristotle is a father of political science. So these, like, we can see philosophers also, they came in that particular place. And not only this one, and we can see now present in what we are discussing, the school. So these, like, of education institutions established by Greek peoples. We can see first educational institution, that is academy. They give a name as a academy. Who is established that one? Plato. So this also one of the important contribution by Greek civilization peoples. So after that, next one here they say, so in that time, next one year came. After that, we can know another one is there are some of other peoples also came, philosophers or writers. So here is one of the important person, Demosthenes. Demosthenes is one of the expert author. After that, Homer is a blind poet. He written by, there are two epics, one is Iliad and another one is Odyssey. So this was one of the important contribution by Greek civilization. After that, we are knowing the father of history, Herodotus. He also came in Greek in only. And another important historians, that one here they're saying by Thucydides, he also came in Greek. And next one here they're saying, after that, they built by temple of Athena and Parthenon, and this one built by Pericles dynasty. This is the best example for Greek architectures. After that, next one here they're saying, on that time, Greek peoples, they studied about the structure of human body. They knowing the knowledge about the structure of human body, and they're expert on that end. We can see Myron was one of the sculptor, and next one here they given Polygetes is one of the famous painter, and Euclid and Pythagoras is a famous mathematicians, and father of medicine, Hippocrates. So these are the peoples, they came in Greek. Just you have to imagine it, not only one field, they established by, we can see philosophers, painter, writer, dramatist. We can see after that, science field in there are some of the important peoples also came, mathematicians. So these, like, we can see there are so much of peoples, they given contribution in Greek civilization. So finally, here they say the Macedonian king Philip destroyed the democratic system of Greece. He destroyed. After that, his son Alexander, a great conqueror, at the age of 20, here they say he conquered by whole world. So after that, here they say, so when he waged the war, he captured so much of place. Here they gave an important place, Egypt, Babylonia, Persia. So these, like, of area he captured by his own foot. He captured and he came to India, till India. So when he back to return at the age of 32, so on that time he died on the day. So these, like, we can see about the civilization of Greek. Is Greek also given, there's so much of contribution to world society. in architecture field, science, philosophy, or writing, poetry, epics, we can see, and Olympic Games. So this way we can see so much of contribution provided by Greek civilization peoples. Okay student, another important civilization, that is Roman civilization. So this also one of the important civilization in the world, because of they given so much of contribution in the field of architecture. And first time we can see they ruled or they took control by overall world, and they have good relationship with also other civilization. So this like we can see some of the special features in Roman civilization. So now we want to know where they established by Roman civilization, and who are the famous kings that came in that particular dynasty, and what was the contribution they are given. So first one here they say the Roman civilization came in Italy. So Italy was one of the important peninsula. Peninsula means we all are knowing what is mean by peninsula. So here they say this also located nearby Mediterranean Sea. And next one here they say, and who are the peoples came in that particular tribals in that particular Roman civilization? For them, they given name as a Latins. They are Latins. After that, here they say Roma was established and the year of 2500 years back. And the district of Latinum of South Tiber River. So in that place, in we can see by Roman civilization. So after that, the next one they are saying Romulus and Remus were the Anastasis of Romans. So they also came in Romans. So now we want to know, now we understood where they are located. In Italy, they all are belong to tribes of Latins. So next one point here they are saying about the Roman Empire or Roman civilization, that is the political history of Roman. So the peoples they came under by control by in that particular dynasty or that particular civilization, and who took the leadership, and what was the political system on that time. So first one here they say, in this scene we can see there are two important kings in Roman civilization. One is Julius Caesar, second one is Augustus Caesar. So both as important king, are here they saying most important person in Roman civilization. So next one here they say Rome, here they saying Pompey and Crassus and Julius Caesar, they first triumvir of Rome, they are first king of Rome. So after that, they ruled different places as a military general. They ruled not a king as a king, they ruled as a military general. So now we want to know, in that team there are two important leaders already told. There are Julius Caesar and another one is, here is saying, next one they given name as a Augustus Caesar. So now we want to know Julius Caesar and Augustus Caesar, what was the contribution they given? So first one we want to discuss about Julius Caesar. He's one of the important military general. And next one here they say he started power between Pompey and Crassus, in that place then he started. After that here they say he murdered by Pompey. Here they say Pompey was murdered by Caesar. So after that here they say, and he defeated by Egypt and felt, here they say, a beauty of Egyptian king Queen Cleopatra, and he married. Julius Caesar, here they say, is like a Pompey, like only he also started by rule in that particular place. After that, he murdered by Caesar. So when they murdered by Pompey, when they murdered by Caesar, after that, here they saying, after that, he married by Egyptian Queen Cleopatra, because of she is a very beautiful. So here next one point here they say, so when he married by Cleopatra, after that he declared by as a dictator, means I am only most powerful person in Rome, other all are we want to surrender, we want to listen what I am saying, that only they want to do. So this like a practice implemented by Julius Caesar. And next one here they saying, so when he married by Cleopatra, after that he destroyed by Republic of Rome, he destroyed the state of Republic of Rome. After that next one here they say, and not only this one, who are their enemies on that time, they given punishment as a assassination, means hanging punishment, he given hanging punishment for enemies. And next one here they saying, on that time when they ruled by Julius Caesar, he given so much contribution in the field of agriculture and industry and trade. So after that, Julius Caesar was introduced. So Augustus Caesar continued the work of Caesar. So after the Julius Caesar period, he introduced by another important person as a king in that particular place, means in particular Roman Empire, that is Augustus Caesar. So here next one they are saying about Augustus Caesar, is the first name is not Augustus Caesar, his name is Octavius. So Augustus Caesar's first original name, that is Octavius. Here they are saying Mark Antony and Lepidus and Octavius formed as a second triumvirate, means second types of land or dynasty. And here they are saying Octavius, he shared the power with Mark Antony and driving away Lepidus and finally defeated by Antony. So finally defeated by Antony, given the power to Antony, and Octavius is become one of the most powerful king in Roman Empire. And next one they say, so when they started to rule in that particular period, particular place, Roman Empire, as a Augustus Caesar, so he is one of the famous and greatest empire in that particular Roman Empire. And in this period, the period of Augustus, they called as the golden period of Roman Empire. And next one they are saying, so we are knowing one of the important person, Jesus Christ, he came in the period of Augustus Caesar and introduced by so much of reformation, social reforms, and implemented by rule of peaceful, and this one called as a Roman as a peace. So in that period Jesus Christ also came and implemented by so much of reformation on that day. So on that based they given name as a Roman peace. And next one they saying, so in that time only the economy and naturally Roman Empire become very healthy or very strong. So these like they're saying, that means now we understood in that Roman civilization we can see there are two important person as a famous, one is Julius Caesar, second one is Augustus Caesar. So next one they say, after the Augustus Caesar, here they say there is no any effective leader in that Roman Empire. There is no strong warrior like a leader or effective leaders did not come. So Roman Empire is decline. So now we want to know what was the contribution given by Roman Empire to world society. So when we are discussing about the Roman contribution, so we want to see they also given so much of contribution to world society, like a Greek. So how Greek civilization peoples they provided by knowledge or contribution, same that like only Roman peoples also, or who are they came in that civilization, they also given so much of contribution to world society. So here one by one they given, Roman they given their so much of contribution in the literary world. So first one here they given, Virgil is one of the important great poet, he written by epic Aeneid. After that Ovid, he also one of the important poet. And Cicero and Plautus was a great literary figures. And Julius Caesar himself as a good historians also. And Cato, Cicero, Seneca, there are famous of philosophers on that time. And next one, they given more importance about peaceful coexistence with nature, how we can live. So this one about only they given so much of contribution. And we can see one of the best example for architecture of Roman Empire, that is Colosseum, and another one is here they given amphitheater. So this one both also best example for the contribution or the knowledge about of architecture. And next one they say Cupid statue and Arapesic sculptures are the best example of their art as sculpting. And next one they say Romans, they have deep knowledge with science and mathematics. Pliny, he wrote the encyclopedia known as natural history. After that Galen is one of the famous surgeon, and Strabo and Ptolemy is a famous geologist, and Roman law served as a basic features of laws. Roman laws, we can see this is a basic law. So in that base law in only, we can see what we are discussing or what we are seeing the constitutions. These all the constitutions came the influence of Roman Empire. So this is also one of the important contribution. And next one they say, and Latin language is become very powerful in Roman Empire, and commonly present even today also we can see Latin language, the words still now using in the field of science, law and other branches of knowledge. We can see present still we are using the language of Latin. So that much of contribution given by Roman Empire. So these are the important points about Greek and Roman. Roman we have discussed, they came in Italian, they all are Latin tribes, and in that there are two important kings. One is Julius Caesar and second one is Augustus Caesar. But Augustus Caesar period we called as the golden period of Roman Empire. He established a peaceful dynasty in that particular place. And we have discussed they have given so much contribution in the field of philosophy, literary, and we have discussed mathematics and architecture also. They have given so much of contribution. So these are the important points about Roman and Greek civilization. So next class we can discuss about next civilization. Okay, thank you.